So I just finished my last ride with Marshmallow. I'm gonna go clean her up a little bit. The hauler is gonna be here in 30 minutes. And I haven't really thought about it a whole lot. And this has been something that I've talked about since I took Marshmallow to the States, because I was gonna sell her when I was down there. It kind of fell through, and it was almost, I thought, like, this might be a blessing in disguise. Like, maybe this is meant to be, that she wasn't meant to be sold just yet. Anyways, fast forward 2 years, we're here, and the same kind of conversation has come up. Why do we need her was the main question. It's kind of like, how do we want to handle this? It was just, hey, baby. It just kind of came down to that I didn't really need her. And she's always been just a really nice, easy, fun horse to have. But it came to the end, it was just kind of, I don't need her. I knew that kind of my journey with Marshmallow was done, and she's ready to move on to be someone's number one. And I just kind of have my plate full. Like, I have things on the go. And Marshmallow is now an open horse, where I typically don't keep horses as open horses. And I was just kind of ready to move on. So I'm just mixed emotions. I'm happy and sad at the same time, but I think it's for the best. And I'm just really excited to see what they can do together and just watch their progress. And that's all as a horse trainer or just a horse owner that's selling their horse can ask for. Even though sometimes my emotions feel like that it's bye forever, and I'm never seeing her again, but that's not true. And it is really rewarding when you can see a horse that you've had and bonded with and really did well with and is ready to move on. And that's kind of, for me, that's like my goal, is I want to have a really nice horse that someone else can get on and they have a really nice horse. And I think Marshmallow is completely ready for that. She's just such a sweetheart. And even for the clinic I did, I was gonna ride her, but then the horse that I ended up lending someone wasn't as good, so I gave them Marshmallow, and she was a doll. Like, she just does whatever you want, and it was not a big deal, and she's just pretty easy. She'll walk, trot, lope a pattern all day long, and that's kind of a rare find, and I don't need that. So she's ready to go make someone else an amazing, fun little barrel pony. Story with this mare, Marshmallow. 2 years ago, my mom went to the BFA, and it was in Oklahoma. And she swore, she promised that she would not come home with a horse. Well, it's pretty ironic that Marshmallow came from the BFA 2 years ago. She looked really sad and just was a little sad four-year-old that was not prepared to be at this crazy environment such as the BFA. Mom's heart got involved and came home with Marshmallow. So naturally, I featured her that year, but the thing that happened that year, I wanted to go to the States and intern for futurity barrel race trainers. And I did. I ended up taking Marshmallow with me because I figured in my head, I need a horse to go with me to learn from these futurity trainers. I'll have my futurity horse. Life will be amazing. We're going to compete and it's going to be awesome. I mean, it did not go like that at all. It was still an awesome experience, but Marshmallow came with me for all of it. She was my little partner. She was the rock I had that kept me on my feet and kept me going and just kind of gave me a reason to know I had a bigger reason to be there. And it wasn't just to clean all these stalls and to feel defeated and to feel let down. It was to learn and grow for her, or for any horse I have after her. And I'm super thankful for her. And this mare, Marshmallow, is the one that started me with IPRA. My first few IPRA rodeos were with her. The first one was last year in Michigan, East Lansing. And I never did IPRA, and we got second place, and it was the most amazing experience. And I am super thankful for this little girl for giving me that. Like, she just completely exceeded so many expectations I had, and we've done a lot together, me and this one. And it's only been 2 years, but those years have been jam-packed of a lot of events and a lot of things that we've done together. And she went with me all over the States, and I mean, she didn't have a choice, but it was just, I don't know, we were there for each other, and that's kind of what it felt like. I literally just cleaned this horse up, put her in the stall for a few minutes, and wait for the shipper. I don't even believe it, Marshmallow. Come on. I just cleaned her so nice. Brush her tail. washed her, just washed her legs. She totally just rolled in so much shit. Okay, let's go. Okay, back in business. And just like that, she's gone. I knew that would happen. It's okay. Bam, that'll be interesting. I'm excited to see their progress now that, like, it's crazy how time, like, things just happen when you know it's happening, and then when it actually happens, it's like, okay, that just, there's no going back. That was it. The last time I'm gonna see Marshmallow for probably a while, considering borders are closed and everything else. But again, that's okay. On to the next chapter. Both of us, Marshmallow and I, are on to the next journey.